two families compete to name the most popular responses to a survey of some simple questions. The answers are locked into our game board and every point is worth 50 rand. In round 3 and 4, the points are doubled and then tripled in round 5. The family with the most points at the end of round 5 play for a jackpot of 75,000 rand. South Africa, it's time to play Family Feud. Give it up for Steve Harvey.
Thank y'all very much. Thank you, everybody. I appreciate that. Thank y'all very much. Well, welcome to Family Feud, everybody in South Africa. I'm your man, Steve Harvey. Well, we got a good one for you today. We're gonna have a good time today. This is the way this show works. I've had some researchers all over the streets of Mzansi.
Yes, baby. Yeah, baby.
They've been asking you for some answers to some very simple questions. Now, we've got those answers to those questions locked in on this game board back here. All these beautiful families have to do is guess those answers, match them up, and the team with the most money, either way, could walk out of here with some serious cash. Yeah. So, I say let's play it. Family Feud in South Africa. Everybody say, let's get it on.
Let's get it on.
From Marina da Gama, it's the Abrams family. Yeah. And from Rylands in Cape Town, it's the Hussein family. Everybody's here trying to win themselves some cash and somebody get a chance to play for the big jackpot, 75,000 rand. All right, you ready to meet the family? Say yeah.
Yeah.
Let's get it on. Give me Clint, give me Shiraz. Gentlemen, welcome to the show.
Thank you for having us.
Okay, you ready?
Ready.
Surveyed 100 people, we got top 8 answers on the board. Name something you should ask on a first date.
How old are you?
How old are you?
Your age.
You don't think you need to know that before you get on this date, partner? Think we need. How old are you?
What are we having to eat?
What are we having to eat?
Yeah.
What are we having to eat? Pass or play?
You play.
Let's go. Now, Clint, I want to just ask you a question about this answer right here. You don't think that maybe you ought to have some idea of how old this girl is before you get on this date. You don't want to get on the date and pick her up and find out she's 16.
I mean, yeah. You want to be sure, you know? She could be 18, she might look 16. I mean, okay. I don't want to go down that rabbit hole.
Yeah, I think you and I should stop this conversation. We should. Because it doesn't sound good coming from me. 18, I'm 62, I don't give a damn what she say. I'm too old to be eating with her. All of my children are older than she is.
Touché.
18. And who is this next to you?
This is my wife,
That's
Portia.
Why we need to shut up right there. That's it, Clint. That's why me and you need to end this conversation right now.
Yeah, it's done.
How old were you when you met?
16. No, I'm joking. 24.
This is gonna be an ugly conversation. You all, and how did you all meet?
We met at work, believe it or not.
At work? Where do you work?
We used to work at a contact center.
Yeah.
When you met her,
yes.
Did you know right away that she was the one?
Absolutely.
The reaction these people just gave you was so pure.
Yes, sir.
So pure. I'm gonna let you introduce your whole family.
Sure, my wife, Portia. This is our cousin, Kim. My mom, Debbie, and my dad, Denzel.
Ladies and gentlemen, the queen.
Yes, yes, yes.
Hello, Miss Debbie.
Hello, Mr. Steve.
You are responsible for all of this.
Yes. I am. With you.
No. No, Denzel. No, wait. Denzel.
No, no, no. Denzel.
Oh, okay.
Denzel wants to be me.
I said Denzel. Oh, hell no. What's up, Denzel? Yeah. No, this is it's her. She. Women are the only people who can make another person.
Yes.
I'm gonna tell you how powerful women are.
Yeah. Mm.
There are over 7 billion people on Earth. Women made all of them. Woo! All of them. Every last one of them. That's pretty big, man. There isn't a man living who has made one single life. That is why we owe women a debt of gratitude that we can never repay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You just can't, man.
Yes, sir.
And what we've got to do, we've got to start teaching our boys that at an early age.
Yes, yes.
Because something has happened in our society today where boys have lost the respect of girls and men have lost the respect of women, and it's creating huge problems here. That has to stop.
Yep.
Yes.
Because you have to honor women. Because without women, you would not even be here.
Yes.
We got to change this, man. That has to happen.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, let's meet the other one. Hey, Portia.
Hi.
What do you do?
I'm an administrator.
An administrator.
Yeah.
Do you all, have any children?
Yes. I have a 3-year-old little boy. We have a 3-year-old little boy.
A little boy?
Yeah.
What's his name?
Ross.
Ross.
Yeah.
Do you have any other grandchildren?
No, just Ross.
This is it.
This is
Ross. Whoa! Ross. He tough little boy.
Ooh.
Climbs on everything, though.
Yeah.
Ross, get down. Watch, I can fly. Ross, you cannot fly. Yes, I can. Watch you. All right, let's play. Name something you should ask on the first date.
What do you do?
What do you do? Kim, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
You're very young.
I'm 24.
Woo! Good answer.
I thought she was like 18 or something. She doesn't look younger than 24? Yeah. What do you do for a living?
I'm a journalist.
A journalist?
Yeah.
Name something you should ask on a first date.
When was your last relationship?
Oh.
That's a good answer. That's a good answer.
When was your last relationship? Miss Debbie, what do you do?
I am retired and I work alongside Denzel in ministry full time now.
In what?
In ministry. In ministry as a pastor. But you'll ask him again.
Oh, the ministry.
In ministry.
Yes. Oh, in the ministry.
Yes.
Oh, the gospel.
Local That's church, right, yeah.
Oh, okay. All right, Debbie. Name something you should ask on the first date.
Do you have a drug problem?
Sit up, sit up, sit up. Do you have a drug problem? Do you have a drug problem? Pastor Denzel, that's good. What's the name of the church? You work at a church or you
pastor? Yes, I do, a local church in Cape Town, yeah.
What's the name of it?
Takai Community Church. Takai Community Church.
Takai Community
yes.
Church. That's good. So, folks, if you're ever in the Cape Town area and you want a warm, welcoming place to worship, please come to the Takai
Community
Church. Open to all in the
Open
community.
Open to everyone. Yes. Yes.
All right, Denzel, name something you should ask on the first date.
So, Steve, I'm thinking ahead. Uh-huh. The question will be, are you free next week?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes, Pastor. All right, now. Pastor's a player. So what's up, girl? Oh, I'm all ready. This is my first question. Man, what you doing next week? Because I got to see you again already. Damn. Are you free next week? Oh. All right, we got two strikes. We have to be careful. Clint, the Hussein family can still name something you should ask on the first date.
Steve, how much money do you make?
Yeah. Whoa.
Whoa. How much money do you make? So says the Slay Queen. How much money do you make? Shiraz, name something. Did y'all discuss this in the huddle at all? Because they having a whole discussion right here. Name something you should ask on the first date.
Steve, we're going to go with, do you have kids?
Yeah. Do you have kids? Number eight. That's right. Seven.
Do you like me?
Six.
Are you a believer?
Number five.
What is your name?
Well, we're off to a good start. Abraham's not on the board. Hussein family got 53. Don't go away. We'll be right back from playing Family Feud, everybody. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. The Abrams family not on the board. Hussein family got 53. Give me Portia. Give me Kotar. Ladies, Portia, did I say it right? What is it, Kotar?
Kotar.
Kotar.
Yeah.
That's good. All right, ladies. Top six answers on the board. Here we go. Name something that shows a man is having a midlife crisis.
He's got a young girlfriend.
Got a young girlfriend. Oh.
I'm going to say going bald.
Green.
Going bald.
Going bald.
Losing his hair.
Going bald.
Losing his hair.
I ain't having no midlife crisis. I just shaved it off. I ain't tripping. Going bald. Kim.
He buys a motorcycle.
He buys a motorcycle. Nisi.
Nasty. He changes his wardrobe.
Changes his wardrobe. Pass or play? They're gonna play. Let's go. All right, Shazam, what do you do, man?
Hi, Steve. I'm the team captain. What I do is I'm self-employed. I have a little sound business where I do weddings and functions and so forth.
Oh, okay, good. Yeah. Like an event planner.
Like a DJ.
Oh,
like
a DJ. Oh, yeah. You do music. Oh. Yeah. What kind of music, man? What type of music?
I like the old stuff, but it all depends on the request of the bride to be at the wedding.
Oh, it depends on like what it is. Like, but you play all kinds of music.
All kinds of music.
Okay, so good. All right, introduce your team.
Okay. Can I get a who?
Sane!
We are the Sane family.
I like that. I like that. That was really clever. I like that.
We are the Hussein family. This is my beautiful wife, Kothar. Next to her, we have my sister, the middle sibling, which is Nazreen. And next to Nazreen, we have Khadija, the youngest, the baby. And the big guy on the end there is Safaraz. He is Nazreen's husband.
You two are married.
That's right, Steve, yeah.
Can I tell you something, Shiraz?
Yeah.
Now, this is a compliment, so don't take it the wrong way.
Uh-huh.
I actually thought that was your daughter.
She's beautiful. She's beautiful.
Really? I really did. And it's not that you look old. It's just that she looks really young.
Oh.
That's what it is. She looks young. It's not that you look old. It's just, don't she look young? Yeah, everybody, that's what it is. Yeah. It wasn't at all. So,
Kothar.
Kothar, what do you do?
I'm a stay-at-home mom at the moment. I'm taking care of our little daughter, baby daughter. And, yeah.
That's a lot of work.
That's what I'm... Yeah, it is.
Good. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Nasreen.
Yes. I'm a operations manager for contact center in analytics.
Okay, good. Khadija.
Yes.
Good. Yes. You're in school.
Yes, actually.
Yeah. What school you go to?
I'm doing my master's in industrial psychology.
A master's?
Yeah. I'm working as well at the same time.
And working where?
Employee wellness.
Employee wellness?
Yeah.
What is that?
Looking after the employees, making sure they're healthy and productive.
Oh.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
So, you look after the employees, make sure that they're doing their jobs and everything?
Yeah.
Oh, you a snitch. You are not doing your job. I am telling the boss. Name something that shows a man is having a midlife crisis.
I would say he's partying.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Oh, partying.
Yes.
I thought... He's partying.
Yes.
I thought she said he parties. you know, just stand there and just pees on herself. He's partying. Safras.
Ah, well done.
My man.
Yeah, well done.
Safras. I've been working on him. I'm getting better.
Good
I'm
job.
Really getting better,
job,
man. What do you do, man?
So I'm a customer service manager at a contact center. I look after about 40 to 50 agents. So I support them daily. I
wow.
love it.
Oh,
love
indeed. It. That's good, man. All right, let's go. Name something that shows a man is having a midlife crisis.
I think you'd buy a new car.
Buy a new car.
Yeah.
Flashy new car.
Good answer.
Siraj, name something that shows a man is having a midlife crisis.
Spending a lot of cash, dude.
Spending a lot of cash.
Good answer, Siraj. Good answer. So good answer.
You only got one strike here. Name something that shows a man is having a midlife crisis.
Start smoking.
Yeah. Start smoking. Nazreen, we gotta be careful now. We got two strikes. The Abrahams can steal. Name something that shows a man is having a midlife crisis.
He just doesn't care about anything.
Just doesn't care
good
anymore. Name something that shows a man is having a midlife crisis.
He gets a tattoo.
Yes!
He gets a tattoo! Number five. Four. Number one. Well, that's round two. The Abrams not on the board. Hussein family got 93. Don't go away. After we come back, the families are gonna double the points. You got plenty of time. It's still early. You're doing fine. We'll be back, y'all. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Abrams family not on the board. Hussein family got 93. Give me Kim, give me Nasreen. Ladies, top six answers are on the board. Here we go. Name something a waiter would ask you.
What would you like to drink?
What would you like to drink?
What would you like to eat?
What would you like to eat? Pass or play?
We're gonna play.
Play. Yeah. Wow. What would you like to eat? I've never heard that. Khadijah.
Yes.
Name something a waiter would ask you.
Table for two?
Yeah. Table for two!
Good answer.
Yeah.
Khadijah, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Have you been out on a couple of dates?
I have.
Yeah.
I have.
Has your father met any of the boys?
Yes.
Did he like any of them?
Mm.
No, he didn't. No. Fathers don't like none of the boys. Two of them, I have four daughters. Two of my daughters are married. I hated them. When I first met them, I hate them. Whenever my daughter brings a boy to my house, I hate them. I immediately hate them, and I informed them of it. I hate you. Now, try to get me to like you. That's all you got. That's all you got. Name something a waiter would ask you.
Would you like the bill?
Yeah. The bill? Oh, the bill.
The bill?
Good answer.
The bill. The bill. The bill. Not would you like the bull. The bill. The bill. All right, we got one strike. Name something a waiter would ask you.
Would you like a menu?
Would you like a menu?
Good answer, Sir Ice. Good answer. Yes!
Kotha, one strike. Name something a waiter would ask you.
Can I get you anything else?
Can I get you anything else?
Yes. Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer.
Nazarene, only one strike. Name something a waiter would ask you.
Would you like extra napkins?
Do you want extra napkins? Khadiji, do you know what I like about you? You look really calm. You look very calm. You're not nervous, are you?
I am. Inside.
She said, hey. All right, you can do it. We got two strikes. Let's be careful. The other family can steal. Name something a waiter would ask you.
Is everything good? Are you satisfied?
Is everything good? Are you satisfied?
Good answer. Good answer. Aww. That's fine. That's
fine. I got two answers up there. Come on, Abrams. Come on. Let's get some points on this board. Okay. Make our life a whole lot easier, I'll tell you that. Name something a waiter would ask you.
Smoking or non-smoking?
Yes. Smoking or non-smoking? Number four. Number three. Well, that's round three, everybody. Abrams not on the board. Hussein, family, 215. But don't go away. After the break, we're gonna double the points. You're still in it now. You're still in it. It's not a problem. You're doing well. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Family Feud, everybody. Abrams family not on the board. Hussein family got 215. Let's go. Give me Debbie, give me Khadija. Ladies, top five answers on the board. Name the last thing people do before they go to bed.
Pray.
Pray. I got you, I got you. They so happy. They needed something. That was a prayer answer. Name the last thing people do before they go to bed.
Good night, my love.
Good. All right now. Yeah. Yeah. Good night, my love. Yeah. All right, Pastor.
Yeah.
Good night, my love.
No!
Clint, last thing people do before they go to bed.
Brush your teeth.
Brush your teeth.
Yes, 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 yes.
Portia, last thing people do before they go to bed.
They turn off the lights.
Turn off the light. Turn off the light.
Yes!
Hello, Kim.
Hi.
Only one strike. Name the last thing people do before they go to bed.
They put on their pajamas.
Yes.
Nope, not me, Kim. I sleep naked. Hey, no pajamas for me.
Oh, yes.
Can't have nothing getting twisted. No, no. I wanna be free. Yes, I do. Put on your pajamas. All right, we got two strikes now. Need this one or else the Hussein family can steal. Name the last thing people do before they go to bed.
They read their Bibles.
Yes, ma'am. We already prayed now. Yeah.
You do both.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm already praying. We ain't gonna be reading this Bible too now. I'm sleepy. I read that Bible, I'm gonna start slobbling on it. Read the Bible. Name the last thing people do before they go to bed.
Steve, we're gonna go with watch TV.
Yeah, good answer.
This, watch TV. Oh, yeah, right there. Number five.
Go to the loo.
Go to the loo. Number four. Well, this is the last round. Now I need both families' attention because now all of you have everything to play for now. Whoever has the most points at the end of this round will win the game and have a chance to play fast money for the jackpot of 75,000 rand. The Abrams family just pulled it out and they now have 156 points. The Hussein family has 215 points. Let's get it on, see who wins it. Give me Denzel, give me Safraris. Fellas, in this round, point values are triple. Surveyed 100 people. Top five answers on the board, here we go. Name something that would make you scream if you saw it in your house.
Dog.
A dog. Yeah. Yo, dog.
Cockroach.
Huh?
A cockroach. A roach. Cockroach, a roach.
A roach?
Yeah. Yes!
Pass or play? Just go
we're playing,
play.
We're playing, we're playing.
Go, come on, pass.
Yes,
go play.
Let's play.
Cockroach!
Say what?
Cockroach!
That's for real, eh? That is for real.
All right, let's go. Name something that would make you scream if you saw it in your house.
A ghost. A ghost.
A ghost.
A ghost.
Yeah. Portia.
Steve.
Name something that would make you scream if you saw it in your house.
I'd say a thief.
Yes, ma'am.
A thief!
Yes!
Kim, only one strike. Name something that would make you scream if you saw it in your house.
A spider.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes,
yes. A spider!
Yes!
Miss Debbie, I already know what you gonna say. But if you go downstairs and you don't see your Bible, you can't scream. So let's start thinking, Miss Debbie, of something that might be on that board over there. One strike. Name something that would make you scream if you saw it in your house.
A rodent, Steve.
Yeah. A rodent! Yes. A rodent! Yeah.
Come on, Denzel boy.
Denzel. Yes. Come on, Pastor. We got one strike, baby. Pull yourself together now. Know you got a lot of power you can call on, but this just a game. Ain't no need of doing that. That'll be unfair. Don't be over there praying and all that. Please, let us just... Dizzy, I don't know what it is, man. I don't know what to tell you, but you only got one strike. You can miss this and dump it all on your team captain, Clint, but if you hit this right here, this one answer left, your family wins the game. Name something that would make you scream if you saw it in your house.
A snake.
Yes.
Yes, DJ. This is for the win. A snake. Oh! Well, family, I gotta tell you something. You all played exceptionally well. You have nothing to be ashamed of. You got a great, y'all played good. Good family, man. Well, you still got 215 points, so you're walking away with 10,750 rand. And KFC is giving you a whole year worth 10,000 rand. So your family can enjoy Kentucky Fried Chicken for a whole year. Enjoy yourself. Great job, man. Great job, everybody. Well, I don't know how you did it. I need two of you right there. I need two of you. Yeah, come on. Fast money. Well, I got Portia.
I could be on this side.
Okay, I got Portia and I got Clint. Fast money, $75,000. $75,000 rand. Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Abrams family won the game. And now it's time to play...
Fast Money!
All right, here's how Fast Money works. Portia, Clint is off stage where he can't see or hear any of your answers. I'm gonna ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. Try to give me the most popular answer. If you can't think of something, you just say pass. You and Clint together come up with 200 points. Look right there, tell everybody what you're gonna win.
75,000 rand.
All right, you ready?
Yes, I am.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name an Olympic sport where athletes have to jump.
A high jump.
Something that would make you feel itchy.
A flea bite.
Something gold that people wear.
A ring.
A career a parent would choose for their child.
A lawyer.
Something you push that has wheels.
A pram. Okay.
All right, let's go, come on. Here we go. All right, let's go. Name an Olympic sport where athletes have to jump. You said? High jump, survey said? Boom. something that would make you feel itchy, you said flea bite. Survey said something gold that people wear, you said ring. Survey said a career parent would choose for their child, you said lawyer. Survey said something you push that has wheels. You said the very popular pram. Everybody knows what that is, of course. The pram. All right, there we go. We just good enough. All right, let's clear the board. Bring out Clint. Well, Clint, Porsche is truly your partner. She got you halfway there. She got 106.
Yes.
You need 94 to win. All right?
Okay, got you.
Now, this is how it's going to work, Clint. We can do this. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're going to hear this sound. I'm going to say try again. You give me another answer. It's going to be a little bit tougher this time, so we give you 25 seconds. You ready?
I'm
ready. All right, let's remind everybody of Porsche's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. Name an Olympic sport where athletes have to jump.
Long jump.
Something that would make you feel itchy.
Mosquitoes. Bugs.
Try again.
Boss.
Something gold that people wear.
Rings.
Try again.
Necklace.
A career a parent would choose for their child.
A psychologist.
Something you push that has wheels.
A trolley.
Something that would make you itchy.
Cross.
All right, let's go. Let's see what we got, Clint. We got 106. We need 94 points. All right, here we go. Name an Olympic sport where athletes have to jump. You said long jump. Survey said? Yes. All right. 68 points away. Oh, the number one answer was high jump.
Oh.
High jump, yeah. Something that would make you feel itchy, you said cross. Survey said?
Yeah.
Grass was the number one answer.
Yes.
Something gold that people wear, you said necklace. Survey said? Ooh. Rings was the number one answer. We need 17 points for 75,000 rand. A career that a parent would choose for their child. You said a psychologist. Survey said.
To the wire, down to the wire.
Doctor was the number one answer.
I was gonna say doctor.
Doctor. Anyway. We need 17 points for 75,000. Something you push that has wheels. You said a trolley.
Come on.
Survey said. Oh! 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 Yeah! Yeah! Shopping trolley was the number one answer, shopping trolley. Well, Abrams family, that's 75,000 rand. Hey, but they got a grand total, 96,600 rand. I'm Steve Harvey. We'll see you next time, folks. Very good. That was very good. I've never heard of that. Never heard of it. I know. Hope y'all had a good time.